Welcome to this week's episode of Ask Your Excel Question. In this week, we're going to learn how we can create all possible combinations of values from two lists. For example, if you have a list of locations and departments, and you want to calculate or create a list of combinations of location and department, like the one you see here on the right. Each location will have different departments, and you'll have New York HR, New York Finance. Similarly, Sydney will have Sydney HR, Sydney Finance. So you want to create all possible combinations of values from two such lists. We can do those using the formulas. So we will learn in this video how to create those formulas. You can use this approach to create such combinations from any two lists of data that you have. And also, we will do it in such a way that it is not limited to a certain number of locations or departments. So you can expand this to as many possible combinations, depending on how many values you have in both of your lists. Before we get started, if you have not subscribed to this channel, please do. If you have any questions or if you have any suggestions for future topics, please post them in the comment section below. Now let's get started. So now let's start with a blank workbook where all we have right now is the list of locations and the list of departments. So first step is to convert these into tables. So I'm going to select them, Control T, click on OK, and we're going to name this as T_LOC, and then the next one, Control T, OK, T_department or DEP. So now we have created two tables. So now we're going to do some counts. So I'm going to just type in counts. And then we are going to count the number of locations. Count A. That's going to give us the counts of locations. And similarly, we want to do a count A, and then select all the values in your table. Close parentheses. Okay, so this is important because now in the future, if we expand the list of locations in the location table or the department, the counts will still be fine. It'll count accurately, and we'll use that in the subsequent formulas. Now, maybe we can name this as C_LOC. This I'm going to name it as C_DEP. Okay, start getting into creating our final table. So our final table is going to have, for example, the row number of the location table. And we'll start with the quotient function because that's going to give us the quotient when we divide it by the number of departments. So I'll explain that. In the numerator for the quotient, what we need is the current row number, basically which row are we currently in. So I will do I3. But this is the first in our table, but this is the third row in the sheet. The row number gives us only the row number in the sheet, not in your specific range or a table. So we need to convert that. So I'm going to hard code this by saying -2 because the previous two rows are there. So I'm going to do -2 to get rid of them in my calculation. And then I'm going to do comma. I need a denominator for my quotient function. So the denominator is going to be how many departments are there. And this is important because each location will repeat that many times as there are departments. So for example, New York should appear in our final table 5 times because there are 5 departments. So I'm going to do the calculation that we made on the count of departments. So I will use that, and then I'm going to close parenthesis and then do it. So then I'm going to expand this all the way to row number 32 here because we already have 2 rows at the top. So I need to go to 32 to have 30 rows in our final table. So the reason why I'm stopping at 30 is because I have 6 locations and 5 departments. So 6 times 5 is 30. So I am stopping here. But if in your case you have 10 times 5, then you can go up to row 52, which is then -2 will give you 50 entries in our final table. So you can expand this as your needs are. Now this, we have the 30 entries, but this is not actually giving us what we want because it's giving us 4 zeros at the top and then it gives us 6 at the bottom. And so that what we need to see is five ones, five twos, five threes, five fours, five fives, five sixes. That's what we want in our table. So it's not really giving us what we want. So let's keep modifying this function or the formula in order for us to arrive at what we want. So this is getting closer. Once I added the plus one, I'm getting four ones. And then if you look at the twos, you have five twos, five threes, five fours, five fives, and then five sixes. The only thing is here, there are only four ones and then 1 7 at the end. So we need to still make some modifications. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the mod function and I'm going to repeat the same as i3 minus 2 comma this. So essentially what I'm saying is if the remainder of this calculation is 0, then don't add any more. Otherwise, add the 1. Okay, so I'm going to close this. And now I'm going to copy this formula over. And now you see that we have every number repeated 5 times. And so if I keep expanding this further, I will see that happen again. So it seems to be working. So just to recap, the formula we're doing is quotient. And then this is nothing but calculating which entry are we currently in, which entry in our table. And then this is the count of departments. So quotient. And then if the remainder is 0, then don't add any more. But if the remainder is not 0, then add 1 more. So that's basically what the logic is. So now we need to calculate the row of the department. The reason why we are doing these row numbers are then in the next few columns, so we're going to actually pull up the location and also the department. So it'll be very, very easy in the subsequent formulas by separating these formulas of the row number in different columns. We can also add all of them into one formula, which will be a little bit more complex. So once you have these individual formulas built, if you're comfortable, then you can combine all of them into one cell. So that's also doable. Now in this video, we're going to keep it simple. So we're going to do them in separate columns so you can easily see how things are working. Now the row of the department, we're going to do it in a slightly different way because we want to leverage the fact that we already calculated the row of location. So now what I'm going to do is count if so what we want to do is to start from our first value here, which is, I'm going to lock the i3 because we start from here and then we want to know how many times 1 has appeared. Okay, now I'm going to hit OK. So how many times 1 has appeared? And then as I keep going down, I want to make sure that it's counting the next one, next one, next one. So you will see that, for example, when in my range here, when I go here, the starting point of my range is still the same, but the ending point is different. That means it's a dynamically expanding range. So as I expand the formula to all of them, you will see that it's counting. And I go to number 2, and now it's counting how many times there are 2s in this range, and there's only 1. When I go here, now there are 2 2s, so it says 2. So it's using a simple countif function. Now that we have the two row numbers, it's very easy now to say, go and calculate the index, or sorry, go and find the value in our location table or the location column here, comma, use the row number that we have already calculated. So it becomes so simple. And now expand the formulas to get it over there. And then department, it's very similar. We're going to go to the department table. And then we will use the row number of the department and then we will expand it out. There you go. So now we have now using formulas calculated these. So in order to do the combination, let's say location hyphen department, we'll use the simple location cell. You can use the ampersand, double quotes, space, hyphen, space, double quotes, ampersand, department. That's it. So now you can see that we have location and the department with a hyphen in between. And now if I change any of the values here, so let's say I do information technology. There we go. Everything updates automatically. You can add it. You can, you know, for example, change the location name or something like that. If you are expanding it more, then you need to expand this also. So let's say, for example, you know, we want to add another city here. And now you see that this is 7 and this is 5. So now I can expand it to, let's say I go all the way here. So now it is easily expanding it to the 7th city, no problem. But now in the last one, because I expanded it to, you know, instead of going only to 35 values, I've gone to the 36th value, and now we start getting errors. And I want to illustrate this because if you're doing it for a different count of locations or departments or any values in your data set, sometimes if you have more entries than the list of locations or departments, then you can overcome this by putting some if error functions, like if error So if you want to do the same for department as well, so what you could do is to say if there is no location, like for example, if this is blank, then don't give me a department because it's not a valid value. So you could do something like this, and now you can expand it out because you see what happened here. Even though there's no location, it was giving you a department because the first department is HR. So if I do something like this, now it doesn't happen. So your data becomes cleaner to look at and use by putting some of these extra logic in place to whenever there is the location is blank, or if you have an error, don't display that. So these are some extra things that you can do to make it even cleaner. We are able to create all the possible combinations of location department in this approach. And so I'm going to delete this set of values because we don't need them. So one thing I would recommend is that the formula that we used here, which is a dynamically expanding range, will not work correctly if you convert this into an Excel table. And then if you expand the table, this formula will not work correctly for one row. And that's just the way Excel works. So that's why I'm not converting this into a table. I'm just leaving it as it is. If I were to convert it into a table, then I would use a different function inside this dynamic expanding range. I would use offset function. So I'm not going to cover that in this video because that'll make it longer. But if you're interested in that solution, please post your question in the comments and then I will create a video separately for that. So now I'm going to go through our steps again. Let's recap it. So first you have two lists of values. So you're going to convert them both into two separate tables. So then you're going to calculate the counts of each of the table list of values. And then we start entering into this table. So the first one we're going to do is the row of location table. And here we use the quotient and the mod functions to actually create a list of repeating values. Depending on how many departments are there, we will repeat the row location that many times. Next step is to create the row of the department table. Here we use a countif function and we will use the row location column and use the countif function to calculate the row number of the department table. Once you do these two things, everything is very easy. Then you're just going to use an index function to get the correct location value from the location row number. Similarly, we will use the department table list of values to arrive at the specific department name using the index function. Finally, we did a concatenation by just selecting the location value and putting a hyphen in between and then putting the department value. Once you have this, you expand it to all the rows as you need, depending on how many locations and departments are there. There you have it. You have all the possible combinations of two lists of values. And this approach can be expanded to any number of locations or departments or any such table. And you can add more and it'll dynamically update here as well. If you found this tip useful, please post your comments. Also share this with your friends. I look forward to seeing you in the next week's episode of Ask Your Excel Question. Thank you very much for watching.